Greetings, minions, and welcome back to Attack of the B-Team Mod Pack with yours truly, the Mad Doctor Frankensores, along with his faithful assistant, Igor. We are both just enjoying a day in the sun here, taking a break from evil science at the tiki bar on the beach, little pina colada in the hand here, trying to stay out of the sun, because as you can see, I've got a little bit of a burn on my face. Yeah, I had a lovely tan before, but I guess I lost that base, and then I went all whitey again, and now I'm pink-faced and burned, and I really need to work on my, I really need to use some sunscreen. I have to remember to put that sunscreen on. Anyway, let me get out of the seat. Hi. So, welcome back. Yes, indeed. I have a new skin here. This is the Mad Doctor Frankenstein, Frankensores, also known as Dr. Sorzo, depending on how you look at things. And this skin was made by a one Masterman 543. It's on the skin decks under Sorzo, S-O-A-R-S-E-A-U. Although I think this is more of a Frankensores with the rubber gloves. And the goggles here. Really like it. Thanks. Thank you very much, dude. And I've been given actually several skins have been forwarded my way via social media and some other methods. And I'm going to go through them all and take a look. I do appreciate all the effort that everyone's putting into the skin that I did ask for, a mad scientist skin in the last episode. So I appreciate the hard work. And I'll probably be trying various outfits on for size every now and then. So today is this one that you see now. Before I forget, because I did forget this in the last episode, so thank you for reminding me. I wanted to do the big tippers. The big tippers from about, I don't know, two episodes ago. We had some folks give me tips about the map and waypoints, as well as, there was something else. Maybe it was a safari gun or something. I don't remember. But these are the folks that gave me some tips, and I happened to capture their names and screenshots. So I wanted to give you guys a shout out. So Selfish Person, there was more to that name, but I couldn't fit it all. Ronaldo Duran, The Real SS Games, and X Scissor. Thank you very much, Big Tippers. Woohoo! Right. Man, what a good day we are going to have today. And I have a plan for us. Gosh, there's so much to do. There's so many things to do with this mod. I don't even know where to begin. Oh, here's a good tip, too. And I had a lot of you mention this. Bing! I can use the safari gun and the safari net to capture Igor. Because I know we were having some trouble with that. Getting him in here with a right click, so we have to use the gun, which works perfectly fine, as was demonstrated right there. Oh no, you can't go in the water. You have little chicken feet. That's not duck feet. You just stay right here and make sure you're under. Are you under? Yeah, get under the bamboo umbrella here, pal, because you look like you might burn too. It looks like your arm's a little overcooked, in fact, your little piggy arm. Yeah, alright, you just stay right there, okay, Igor? So here's what I want to do. I've got a list of things here. Let me take a look. Yeah. Oh, trapped. Oh, yeah, yeah. Check this out. You've probably already seen this on everybody else's videos about this. These hidden doors. We can use the Tinkers. Oh, no, I'm sorry. This is the Carpenter's mod. Carpentry mod, whatever it is. And we can hide these doors. We can camouflage them, right? So this is really cool. Let me get my hammer and show you the other designs. Oh, darn. Let's get all that in there. I don't have my hammer on me. So let's go down here. We'll do this really quickly. And then we have a fun build that I want to do together. And I'll tell you about that in a minute. Okay. So what I wanted to do then is show you guys how to make these. Again, real simple. And whoops. Press U, R, press R to show how to make it. Right, there it is. So it's basically sticks, and if you happen to have a helmet, just toss it in there, right? And a block in the center. So really easy to make. In fact, let us make a few More. And you get multiple. I think you get five per build operation. Yeah. Boom. Nice. Okay. Pretty cool stuff that. Now, what we want to do with this is you can make a door. You can shape this just like you would a normal wooden block door, right? A wooden door, and this gives us a carpenter's door. I already have one, obviously, and I'm not going to make another one right now. I want to save these blocks for some other stuff. But and this is one of the things I want to do right now is a trap. Oh, that's a pressure plate. Can we make a trap door? Yes, hatch. That's what I wanted. Hatch. Right. Because I wanted to hide this. I wanted to hide this. Oh. Oh, wait, no. Oh, shoot. Yeah. I think I'm just going to get rid of this. Because everybody knows about this, but I want to get rid of that. I want my secret hideout to be, well, somewhat secret. And if I don't, oh man, I'm going to have to make this flush. I think we can still do this. Let's try it. I don't, you guys don't jump down in the hole. Ah! Oh, darn it. Stuff breaks too easy, this bamboo. Don't let them out, they're savage little beasts. All right, we're getting there. We're getting there. Now, I have not tried this. A lot of this stuff I'll practice off camera, so I kind of don't derp around too much here. And I don't really use this hatch very much anymore anyway. Now that I can bat my way in, I can just fly in as a mini bat, so it's not that big of a deal. All right, let's just make one more piece of bamboo here so I can block this off. Because Jenny actually. Oop. Jenny B came by here on his RV, and I'm going to show you that clip in a minute. When I go off and do some collecting down on the Nether, because I need some stuff from the Nether, I'm gonna roll that footage, and I want to show you. He showed right up in his RV. It's hilarious. I'm gonna show you that in a second. But he went right down here. He knows exactly how to get down to my secret base. He knows it exists, so it's not that. I guess it's not that secret after all. But all right, let me grab some dirt. Actually, grass. I need a block of grass because I hope this works. I haven't actually tried this. We're gonna use that for the camouflage. Come on, Betty. Don't you be eyeballing that hole. I see you looking down there, wagging that little tail. Must have jumped down there and escaped. Oh, so you're orange today, and you're like a pink plaid thing. No. Scoot your little butts back over there in the corner. I really need to do something with these guys because I feel bad that they're just hanging out here. They don't get much attention. Let's see if this works. So if I put this flush here, so there it is, bang, right? And we can make it multiple styles with the hammer. That's so cool. We just want it flush with the ground, and then we camo it with grass. And you have to, it actually does steal the block, and it applies it to the surface. And then bang. Huh? Don't tell anyone. Shh. I'll cook you up if you tell anyone. All right, so that's cool. Now, so that's exactly what I did over here. Pretty cool stuff. And bang. So, all right, let's do something. Now, let's take a look at the map here for a quick moment. So we've got my, let's bring up the big old map. So we've got my Necro Altar here. This is going to be Monster Island. I may actually convert this into a paradise island, a kind of a vacation island. We will have like a resort. And then this is my tiki bar. So my thought process is here. I use this to entice people here, right? We need to get tourists over here so that we can snatch them. Snatch them people up. And then turn them into monsters and use their body parts. That's kind of the theme, right? All right, let me just get organized. And I'm looking for. I can't turn that rain sound off now because I don't have Optifine on here anymore. Because we have an update on the server and the client as well, so I had to make some changes, and I haven't put I need spider eyes and everything, string spider eyes.
Oh baby,
ow, nasty baby. So I haven't been able to put Optifine in. Let me show you what we have now. This is going to be so awesome, guys. I love Bibliocraft. I use this in my Legend of Hoodie series as trophies, right? We can make desks. You can put books on top of these desks. There are lamps, a lot of cool furniture. Very excited about this. We just added this one in. Okay, let's do this. Make it really quickly here. I was hoping to use jungle wood for this process. Why don't we use jungle wood? So basically, it's this. Let's get in here where we can get the actual... I'm going to need slabs. So let's make some slabs. Get the actual recipe right in the crafting bench. Oh, yeah. And there's another tip here, too. So thanks for these tips, man. If I could just remember them all. If I hold shift click, if I have these items in my inventory, hold down shift. I'm holding it down right now. Click on that. It fills it. Wow. That's awesome. Now watch this. All right. Get. Go away, vines. All right. Let's just spread you over there. Now, I'm going to be doing a lot with storage here eventually when I figure out how all the storage works. But for now, we're just going to make do. We're using very old school Minecraft shelves and benches and chests here. But we don't have to be old school, do we? Because we have all this new stuff to play around with. Now, so that's how that's going to look. Let me turn into the mad doctor. Okay, there we go. So, just to get a good scale. Now, let me show you how this works. So, let's say... I'll make a bookshelf, too. Do I have enough wood for a bookshelf? How much wood does a bookshelf take if a bookshelf could say wood? Yeah. There! Nope! Don't. Let's just make one bookie shelf. And memory bad. So, that I... Bing! Oh, man! Okay, let's save that wood for something else. Okay, a bookshelf holds, well, what do you think? I'll give you one guess. Come on. All right, yes, books. I gave you three guesses and the first two don't count. That's what my dad used to say. All right, let's put the books here then. Bing. Where do you get a book? Bang. Boom. Huh? Check it out. Let's make one more thing with Bibliocraft, and then we're going to do the real project that I came here to do with you, and we're going to make a jungle desk. Oh! Feather. I got one. Bing! Okay, so we has everything we need for a jungle desk. Monkeys not included. Bing! Got it. Get it? Monkeys not... Whatever. Now, I'm going to have, like, a library area. This is going to be... like a workshop area. I'm probably going to move all this workshop stuff over here. I'm not really sure yet. I have to think about it. And the floor is... This is not going to be the ultimate flooring in here is going to be something else. And I've been kind of toying around with... I put my hammer away, didn't I? Dang it. I've been toying around with this stuff because you can put those carpenter blocks down and just drop designs on them. And I was trying... Oh, you can see it right here. I was trying various designs. So that's just time consuming. It's just going to be a matter of time and practice or just trial and error kind of stuff. And I'm not really ready for that. But let me show you the desk. So if I have, I'm going to have like a study, right, with lots of books. So let's just, well, we'll put it over here. This is really just for demonstration purposes. So bing, there's my desk. Now you can interact with this thing with a shift. Okay, we have to put something on it. Let's go over here and get the books back. Hello. Now, you can open this up like this and get stuff off, or you can actually just pop them off, too. Pop! No. Silly gate. That. To hold down shift, right-click, and you can pop it off. Just pop it off. And this one, you can stack books up like that. Whoops. Oh, you can read it on the desktop, but you can have an open book, too. Check it out. We can stack them up like that, but sometimes you can just drop them on right in the world without going into the graphical user interface. The GUI, as they say. Pretty cool. We got the candle here. We got the pen. Huh? Awesome. I'm really looking forward to Bibliocraft. We have lots of options here. And these are great, too. You can stick these up on the wall and put, like, you know, maybe chop someone's head off and put it in there. You know, basically for your trophies, your, things with sentimental value and that you want to display and share with, you know, everyone that comes by and visits. So let me just show you how these things work, though. All right. Bing. Boom. Huh? Right in the world. You see the whole darn thing. Is that not amazing? You bet your sweet bippy it is. I'm telling you, this is going to be so cool. You can have, and then if you want it, oh, you just pop it right off. It just pops right off. Look at that. Bam. And that's so nice. So think of the possibilities, my friends. We're going to have, this place is going to be just outstanding as a mad scientist, evil doctor's workshop, laboratory, whatever you want to call it. So we could put anything up there. And there's also the potion. There's a potion one too, so you can put potions. So that Chim's going to go nuts with the potion one. Oh, there's a tool rack as well. But we're not going to make any more of those. Because what I want to do right now is something even cooler than all that jazz. And, man, I wish... There's, like... I wish we could wear this and still have our skin showing. You know, kind of like a social slot in some games. Maybe there is, maybe there isn't. But if there is, let me know. All right. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go collect everything I need to get this boat project made. And if we have time, I'm going to throw some of Jenny's RV visit in right now. While you guys watch that, I'm going to go to the Nether and get the stuff I need there. So I shall return. Don't go away. And have some... Here, this stuff is so delicious. Oh my gosh, did you hear my stomach? It's my lunch break right now and I'm starving. I'm thinking about this jerky. What kind do you want? We have all types. We have teriyaki. That's that. We have this is Tabasco sauce. Wow, you guys are eating those right up fast. Okay, slow down now. Slow down now. Well, seriously, where the heck are those going? Are they coming back to me? They're disappearing. You want low salt? Oh, there you go. Low salt. This is the vegan variety. Yep, no zombie flesh. Well, 32% zombie flesh. The rest is seaweed and vines. So, you know, not totally vegan, but well, whatever. Anyway, okay, I'll be right back. Don't go away. Egads! It's Cousin Jenny! Cousin Jenny B! You can't park that thing on my beach! You get him, zombie! Whee! This is a riot. Taking a little cruise here. Let's cruise chicks. Let's cruise chicks, Jenny. Cousin Jenny. Alright, my minions, I have returned from the Nether with 41 blocks of quartz. That should be plenty to build this boat, and that is what we're going to do right now. Unfortunately, under the moonlight, but looks like there's plenty of light to see by. Can you just hold a flashlight for me, Igor? Just shine some light up. That. Yep. What do you mean, safari gun? Oh, right. Okay. Okay. So it's good to get Igor involved. He feels a little left out at times. So here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna put down a base of a boat, and then we're going to activate it with Archimedes' helm, which is this guy right here. Very simple to make. And that's what I love about these ships, is that there's no redstone involved. There's no fancy contraptions or gizmos or hooky what's-its and who's-y what's-its and that sort of thing. So it's just really simple. And I no! It just rained last night. And then I stopped because I didn't want to record this in the rain. And now it's raining again. All right. Let's wait for the rain to stop. And maybe it'll be sunny by the time the rain stops. And then we can build this darn boat. Ah, okay. Code words received. Thanks, Chimney Poo. It's good to have a resident witch that has the power to control the weather. Well, I left at nighttime, but I guess witches like the night, right? So I guess beggars can't be choosy. We'll just have to take what we can get. Okay, enough of that. Let's get started here. And I think I can build right in the water. Although, I want to... No, let's get it up above the water. We're going to build it right here on the beach. And by my workbench and stuff, so you don't have to travel too far. Now, I have messed around with this a bit in creative on a single-player world. So let's see if I remember. So it's basically going to be a 4x3 there, and then a 1, 2, 3, 4. This would be the nose. This would be the rear end. Now, we don't need a floaty. Apparently, there's a floaty block here that we can make an air balloon, and this will give it, well, that gives it the capability of flying, but there's also this one right here, a floater, which we don't necessarily need because this, in my testing, it floated just fine. I think that gives it buoyancy. It determines how high it floats up in the air. But I think we're going to be pretty good as is. So let's grab the stairs and just continue on the way it looks right now. Dang, yo, I'm flying around and missing. Okay. Bad aim as a bat. And there's one thing you have to be careful of when you're building as a bat. Sometimes blocks literally will just go poof in your hands. They just disappear and you lose it. And I can't afford to lose. Oh my gosh, that goes fast. I can't afford to lose any of these. Because I am right at the wire here. On the wire. In the wire. Did I get that back? Oh, crud. Well, it should float. It's supposed to float when it hits the wall. Oh, no. Did you guys see that? Gone. Ridiculous. Come on. Now I need you back. Get back. Thank you. Oh, now I got it. There it is. Okay. Was it there the whole time in my inventory? Did I just not see it? This is why I don't like to work at night. It's also hazardous. You should get hazard pay for this kind of work. All right, Igor, you're paying attention. I might ask you to build a boat someday, and if you're not watching, then you won't know what to do. Ooh. Ooh. Do I actually need any of these? Let me make, because I still need some stairs. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Now, I don't have a fortune pick or anything, so I was getting one for one every time I was taking this the quartz. But I'm telling you right now, in the next episode or two, we will definitely arg. I think I need like one more stair. Just one. I'm gonna have to go back and get some more people. Oh, I'm sorry. Because I was getting one for one when I was picking, you know what I mean? So, kind of a shame. Anyway, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, can you come back to me as something different? No. That's so sad. All right, we'll have to hold off on the slabs, or maybe I can just use a different type of slab. I kind of wanted to keep the whole thing white. But, in fact, I believe, yeah, shoot, I need one on the nose. I need one on the nose right here, a slab. Maybe I can make a stone slab, might not look too badly. All right, well, let's just continue on with what we has, and then we'll deal with it. We'll deal. It's all good. So now what we're going to do is put some fine cherry wood, I like to call this cherry wood, the jungle, on the sides here. So we'll have a nice wood trim. So far, so good. What do you think, Igor? Thumbs up. Never mind. Okay. We don't want to embarrass him. He doesn't have any thumbs. Neither do I. Speaking of, ja. Do I? Oh, especially not as a bat. Oh, funny. All right. So now, what we want to do is put. Oh, we are going to need another stair, actually. Anyway, here as the seat. And I think the seat's going to go there. All right. And we're going to put a chest here. So I have some props we're going to throw on this bad boy, too. And we'll save those for last, in fact. So, tell you what. Let's get all the colored. I had some colored wool I wanted to put on this darn thing. Oh, shucks. I was going to get one back, too, right here. One back. But that's not enough. I need one more block. All right, well, that's a quick trip to the Nether. We'll go get that. Let us make glass panes. Yeah, grab this glass. Now, watch this. Check this out. This, if you make glass, well, that's a hamster ball. We don't need a hamster ball. Put that in the center. One ink sack, and you get this bubble glass. Check that out. Huh? And if I had my chisel, I could show you various chiseled forms of this. You can put designs on it, but we don't want to chisel it.
No.
What we want to do is
no.
Oh, wait. No, 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 no. I think we want to chisel it. I'm trying to get glass paint, bubble glass panes. How do we get bubble glass? Dang you.
Squilly Wabbit. Squilly Mad Science.
I'll tell you what. Here's what we're going to do. We can do this too, because I have a backup plan, you see? Bing. Forget the bubble glass, we'll just go with borderless. I will figure that out later, and... I think I need my chisel. Alright, something's going on. How do I make these darn panes? I figured it was just the actual glass and the paint. Maybe that's chisel. Let me go get my chisel. But I really just need streakless glass. But I need them. I need them to be panes. And I tried actually putting panes in the chisel, and that didn't work either. So I know what you're thinking. But that doesn't work either because I've done this before as well, folks. Trust me. I've.
Whoa.
All right. Oh my god. I don't even know. I tried that in single player. I swear. On Igor's mother's grave that I tried that in single player and it did not work. Anyway, that's exactly what I'm looking for. We want a little glass front, you see? Not too shabby. And now, for more props, I shall open this chest. All right, I grabbed some sheeps over here, by the way, if you notice. Go orange. Hey, nice crown. I would kill you for it, but I need your wool. Don't talk back to me. You're lucky you're even here. Can I shave your crown right off your head? You think you're the king of me? You think you're the boss of me? Huh? Churlish and insubordinate. Something like that. Okay, we'll just do that. That ought to do. All right, then. Now, I think I had this all planned out. Boom. Boom. No, 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 no. Oh, wait, did I do it that way? That's okay. I think I had white there before in my single-player world, but we'll mess around with that. And I also want some blue, and we can do that right here. Got plenty of blue. So let's do this. I think I was going to make some carpet or something, too. So the props really, yeah, whatever. You know, props are fun and all. But we could just mess around with these. Doesn't really matter how we go with these props. Let's just dump a junk in here. Bunch of junk in here. And Igor is just like, this guy. Do I actually have to work for this guy? He doesn't know what he's doing. I guess let's make the helm now. Let's make the helm because I think we're just about done. And I am actually going to have to get one more in front here. And I'll go collect that. So let's make the helm. Wait, a couple more props, actually. My bad. Let's do this. We're going to put some stairs. I mean, some a ladder. and we're going to do that, like, here. And then put you there. So this will give us a way up when we're down there. Or if we fall out of the boat and we want to climb back out. Oh, yeah, baby. So this is actually going to have a front on it like that, but I'm gonna change that out with white. All right, so let's just do we'll put the white slab. Oh, that's not right. No, 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 no. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go back and get some. Whatever, you know that. Okay, so now let's see. So there's a few minor little tweaks here that we're gonna have to do, because again, this I want that to be white. And this is just a substitute, a temporary substitute for now. And then maybe, you know, a little color on here, I think, like that. This could be life jackets or something. I don't know. I'm going to play around with that. And now let's just make the thing that makes it go. And that is the helm, which is this little fella. And easy enough. Oh. What? What don't I have? I guess it didn't want to help me out this time, huh? Oh, maybe I didn't hold down shift. That's my bad. Okay. So many buttons to remember. Okay, so now we have the helm, and we plopped that guy right there. And I wanted to make... can I get... Nope. You're not going to give me that back, are you? Turkey. Mm-hmm. Put a blue carpet. Now! Get out of the boat! Get out of the seat, I mean. Yeah, right. Like that. Okay. Okay. Yes, 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 yes. What do you guys think? That's not bad. Not bad for a ham and egger, as they say. And I'm going to take this now, because this is going to go on the back side. And we're just going to chuck some stuff in here so I can just have some room to drive. And this goes here. And I wanted to make a, well, it was going to be like this, but again, I have to go back to the nether and get some more nether quartz. I just need a few white slabs left, but I think, yeah, because what's going to happen when I put that white slab here, the quartz slab here, I can turn this around so it's not so flat like that. But we'll play around with that another time. I think it's time for a quick drive. Igor, you want to go for a drive? The new boat. And I'm going to make a dock here. You know, have a nice dock. Not right in front by the beach, of course, but we'll have it over here somewhere, you know, on the side. And I'm going to be tooling around in this thing back and forth between all my my locations. Do you want to watch? I don't think there's a seat for you, my friend. Sorry. This is a one-seater only. And it's time for the maiden voyage. Oh, I should probably put some headlights on this thing. What do you think? I think so. Let's check the secret hatch. Make sure this works. Yes! Now. Okay, let's do it, baby. Bing! Oh, let's drive! Archimedes ships. Oh, no. Yes. All right. Here we go, people. Yeah! Oh, yes, this is great. Okay. And maiden voyage, break a bottle of something on here, please. Get a bottle of champagne. Igor, give me some champagne. Cricket, cricket. Ah, good help is hard to find. Let's go. Yes, it works. It works. Without it, it's just magic. We don't need any fancy redstone. Oh, no, a cape. Get rid of that darn cape. I don't want a cape. It's white. Somebody bleached my cape. Igor, did you do the... He did the laundry again, didn't he? Way too much bleach. Look it! Look, we're here already! This doesn't crash, does it? Oh, this is amazing! There's probably some awesome music playing right now. I'm going to add that in. I'm going to add that in. Some floaty sailing music, probably. Sailing. Although it's technically not a sailboat. It is a speedboat. It's a kick-butt speedboat, kids. All right, so I think, this is a pretty long episode, but this is cool. Look at this. We can just buzz around between all of our islands, and I'm going to take this for, like, a little trip. We're going to do some exploring, because look at this map. It's all, I'm right in the ocean, so this is going to be so fun. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think we're done here. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and if you did, please... As I always would request, a like is always appreciated. It shows me that you care, and it does indeed help my channel. Welcome back, my minions! I just wanted to share with you a couple of minor improvements I have made to my speedboat before I let you go. As you can see here, I have added a second seat. That's a passenger seat in the back. That's part of the Archimedes mod, in fact. And it does indeed allow me to carry a passenger around. So all they have to do is click on that seat and they get attached and off we go. Pretty cool stuff. And because of that, I had to move my captain's chair just a little bit forward, but that's okay because I got little short legs here and it looks like I'm really sitting in the chair now, right up against the steering wheel. So not so shabby. And then the chest I put right in between the two chairs there. And I also went down to the nether and got some more nether quartz, so I replaced that awful wool. Those wool slabs. So I think we're good here. This is looking really nice. I'm very happy with it. And once again, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And we'll see you next time. All right. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.